When we think of Russia in the early 20th century, on a political level, we mostly think of the extreme left that managed to gain power in 1917 and consolidate its power in the subsequent years. In this video, we're going to take a look at a peculiar faction. We're going to talk about the extreme right Black Hundreds. Played a vital role in the anti-Jewish pogroms of 1905. Stay tuned. And welcome to this very first episode of a new video series called Factions. In this video series, we're going to take a look at political and paramilitary organizations from the past. In this video, we're going to talk about the extreme right wing, the Black Hundreds. Who were these men? What were their ideas? And how did they end up? Since the start of 1905, several right-wing groups were established in Russia. One of them was the Russian Monarchist Party, who strived for the restoration of a strong autocracy, martial law, dictatorship, and the suppression of the Jews, who they claimed were responsible for the disorder in the empire. Then there was the Russian Assembly, that strongly advocated against the introduction of Western parliamentary institutions. They lived by the old formula of autocracy, orthodoxy, and nationality. And then there was the Union of the Russian People, founded by Alexander Dubrovin, that wanted to mobilize the people against the forces of the left. This organization was also supported by the Tsar himself. What these groups all had in common was that they were anti-socialist, anti-liberal, and above all, anti-Semites. Because they saw the Jews as the cause for the problems that had occurred within the Russian Empire. These movements can be seen as an earlier Russian version of fascism. The Union of the Russian People, they believed that the Tsar was not able to restore order by force, and therefore they had to help him. And so, the paramilitary organization of the Black Hundreds was born. The name was a derogatory one, adapted from the term White Hundreds, which was used in medieval Russia for the privileged caste of nobles and wealthy merchants. The lower class types who joined the Black Hundreds were not in this class, hence their ironic nomenclature. They marched through the streets with patriotic flags, portraits of the Tsar, and religious symbols and icons. However, they also were armed with knives and knuckle dusters. So who became a member of these Black Hundreds? Uprooted peasants who were forced to come to the city to seek work, craftsmen that faced severe competition by bigger businesses, and low-ranking officials who feared to lose the little power they had to democratic reforms. And also common criminals joined up. Many of them were released in October that year. And so they marched through the streets and beat up everyone who they deemed to be either Jewish or a democratic sympathizer. Many people were forced to kneel down before the portrait of the Tsar or kiss the patriotic flags they had with them. But this here was nothing compared to what the Jews had to endure. In the 2 weeks after the Tsar announced his reforms in October 1905, a number of 690 pogroms took place, in which Jewish residences and neighborhoods were attacked by angry mobs of the Black Hundreds that often incited these pogroms. It left 3,000 people dead. The worst pogroms took place in Białystok and Odessa, where in the latter city, 800 Jews were killed, 500 wounded, and 100,000 lost their homes. And investigations showed that the local police did not only encourage the gangs by supplying them with vodka and weapons, but they also took part in it. Pogroms in the Russian Empire were unfortunately nothing new. Only recently, in 1903, during the Easter, the Kishinev pogrom in Bessarabia, now Moldova, claimed around 50 lives and left many homes damaged. Nicholas II supported the pogroms and saw the Jews as responsible for the political turmoil in his empire. After 1907, membership of the Black Hundreds declined, and after the February Revolution of 1917, the organization became outlawed. After the October Revolution, many of the former black hundreds, they left the country or they joined the whites to pick up arms against the reds. And as we saw during this devastating conflict that became known as the Russian Civil War, also many anti-Jewish pogroms occurred during this conflict. And I can tell you that the pogroms that occurred in the violent aftermath of the Russian Revolution in Eastern Europe made the pogroms of 1905 look like a small riot. I'll cover this in the future. Thanks to my patrons you see on screen, and a special thanks to Joanne, Peter King, Tanya Dixie, Henry Clarkson, Rob Park, RL, and Colleen Castleman. Now, this video has a lot of violent photos and is obviously demonetized, but nevertheless, I do want to point this out. If you want to know more about what happened to the Jews in the Second World War, I also made some videos about that on location. If you want to know more about the Lviv pogrom, you click right here. If you want to know more about the Holocaust by bullets, you click right here. And if you want to know more about the whole story of the Holocaust, which I recorded in the remains of Auschwitz-Birkenau, the former extermination camp, you click right here. Never forget.